The objective of a Carnot engine, a Carnot heat engine, is to convert heat into work continuously. And this is a schematic representation of the behavior. We take heat at high temperature, so QH is energy in a form of heat being transferred into this Carnot cycle. Some of the heat goes to work and the rest is rejected at lower temperature to a low temperature reservoir. For this ideal case, and of course the Carnot cycle is ideal in itself, but we're looking at the case where the low temperature of the Carnot cycle is the same as the low temperature reservoir, and the high temperature reservoir is the same temperature as the high temperature in the Carnot cycle. Of course, we need a temperature difference for heat transfer, and we're looking at the extreme, so as the temperature difference gets very small, the heat transfer, of course, would take a very long time. But we can still do the calculations treating this as one approach. And what we want to do is then apply the first law and the second law to this process. And what we're going to do is apply it to the cycle. The first law we can apply is QH plus QC plus W equals zero. That's just applying it around the Carnot cycle, where you have to be careful for sign notation. QH is now energy being added. That's positive. QC is energy being taken away. That's negative. And W is also energy being taken away, so that's negative. The second law says delta S for this Carnot engine is zero. And the reason is we have, for example, some gas going through this cycle. And it starts here, moves through the cycle. Later time, it's back to where it started. State function entropy cannot change, and it keeps going around and around many times. So delta S for the cycle is zero. If we now calculate delta S, heat over temperature, the high temperature 600 degrees for the cycle, and then heat over low temperature, that must add to zero. And so what we're going to look at is the numbers for the case where we're going to assume that we have 500 joules. Make it easier to see how this works. 500 joules is being transferred in. We have the two temperatures. And so first law says 500, and it's positive because we're adding energy, plus QC plus W is zero. The second law says 500 divided by, so this is joules and this is Kelvin, has to be absolute temperature. Doesn't make sense unless we use absolute temperature. QC, we don't know. The low temperature is 300 Kelvin. That's zero. So here's the two entropy changes. It means we can solve for QC. It's going to be minus 5/6 times 300. So that's minus 250 joules. And so this is minus 250 joules. We can go back to the first law, 500. Minus 250 plus W is zero. W is also minus 250. So for this particular cycle and these choices of temperature, we're saying is we can put 500 joules in and we get half of it out as work and the rest we reject to low temperature. Of course, the first point is we can't convert all the heat into work. We have to reject heat at the low temperature. We can talk about a thermodynamic efficiency as the work over QH. So when we're looking at this, this is what we desire. This is what we could sell. This is what we have to pay for to create the process. We'd like this number to be as large as possible. In our case, it's 250 over 500 or 0.5. Okay, so this is the thermodynamic efficiency for a Carnot cycle, for this particular Carnot cycle. And in general, if you look at this definition, we can talk about the efficiency, work over QH. Well, work is QC plus QH. This will be a positive number over QH. So this is 1 plus QC over QH. We can show that this is equal to 1 minus TC over TH. So efficiency for a Carnot cycle is just related to the temperatures. Absolute temperature must be used in this calculation. So let's look at why we can make the substitution. The second law, we said QH over TH plus QC over TC is equal to zero. And so that means QH over TH is minus QC over TC, or QC over QH, TC over TH with a minus sign. This then is the substitution that we made here to get deficiency just in terms of the temperatures. So note that this is an ideal Carnot cycle. Doesn't mean we can actually run this in real life. It's an indication of what's the best. So this is the best efficiency between these two temperatures. Right? We need a high temperature energy source. We need a low temperature to reject the heat. We're not going to do as well as this, but this gives us a benchmark on how well we can do. So let's go back and look at our cycle. And let's make a change to see what happens if we were to look at conditions that might be more realistic. So the first thing is, let's assume this is 700 and this is 250 Kelvin. Right, so I'll call this TH with a prime to distinguish it from the TH of the cycle, TC of the cycle, and the TC prime. And now I want to look at the energy being removed from this is a high temperature reservoir, stays at this temperature. So I'm going to look at QH prime. And the only thing different is now if I look at my reservoir as my system, I'm removing energy from it, so that's minus. I'm going to go down here and look at QC prime. Now that's plus. And we've already calculated these numbers. The cycle here has not changed, so all these numbers are the same. This is positive when I look at the low temperature reservoir as my system. If I look at the Carnot cycle as my system, of course, this then is negative. If I now analyze this, we've introduced irreversibility, right? Irreversible because there's significant temperature difference. Delta S for this engine has not changed. It's still zero. It's still running around in a cycle. First law for it has not changed. But delta S for the reservoirs has changed. For the high temperature reservoir, QH prime over TH prime. And then for the low temperature reservoir, again, these values. So QH minus 500 joules. High temperature reservoir is 700K. The QC is positive, and the temperature for the low temperature reservoir 250K. So this is minus 0.71 plus 1.0 joules per Kelvin. So delta S for the reservoirs is 0.29 joules per Kelvin. This is positive. Delta S for the engine is zero because it's running around in a cycle. Delta S for the universe is 0.29 joules per Kelvin. It's greater than zero because it's irreversible. The idea is we could not put 700K and 250K into this equation here for the efficiency. And so now we have higher temperature in order to make the process work, but we didn't get more efficiency. We're getting the efficiency of the high temperature of the Carnot cycle.